Hey folks, Lemonade here, and I think we have to call 2023 the year of the glass pads, because boy, they're coming one after another. And today we get to look at the company known for their control pads. But does that character bleed into this new glass pad? Well, we're going to check out all the details on the new GameSense Sonar right after this. Small disclaimer, GameSense did send me this out free for review, but that will never change the outcome of any review on this channel. My opinions are my own, and you are seeing this as early as they are. Okay, let's knock out the specs real quick, and I'll throw those right up here for you folks. I want to cover some ground real quick. This is the limited edition Meanwhile, which is sold out, so the only available option at the time of filming is their all black pad. Nothing is different in terms of characteristics as far as I'm aware, besides the design, of course. That said, I fully expect to see more designs coming down the road, as GameSense is really known for their iconic designs on the Radar series. Speaking on this particular design, I really love this thing. It's super unique from a lot of designs that we see on the market currently. It really has its own character, plus it brings in a personal touch. The founder of GameSense is a Korean American, and he wanted to showcase some kind of traditional Korean art in this piece. The design is a bit more hazy on the surface due to the etching of the glass. That's pretty common on most glass surfaces, as you can see how much cleaner the design looks on the back of the pad. Also, I'll be comparing this to some other glass pads and a few cloth and hybrid pads with some new Lemonade pseudoscience. More on this later. With that out the way, let's chat about the pad for a moment. It comes nicely packaged in this gorgeous box for the Meanwhile and a slightly less gorgeous box for the all black. It's lined with interior foam, pretty much identical to how SkyPad or Pulsar do their package. Now at first glance, probably most of you are thinking this probably is a lot like other glass pads on the market. And hell, I thought the same thing, but thankfully there are a couple different things that set this apart from the others. But obviously you'll have to determine yourself if that's worth it to you. The first thing that's a bit different, which I love, are these beveled edges. They are just so damn smooth and rounded. They really kind of allow you to glide a bit more consistently over the edge without kind of feeling snagging or getting caught on the edge. And it's really the best of any pad I've tried, as you can see in these shots to compare. That said, it's not a total win over the other glass pads. The pad thickness here with the rubber feet measures on my tool at 4.8 millimeters. My Serapad Kin is also 4.8 millimeters, but the Superglide is 4.3 and the SkyPad is 3.6 millimeters. So while yes, this is very comfortable and an improvement over my Kin, it's less of an issue on the Superglide or the SkyPad because of their thinner profiles. And second is the base. Unfortunately, GameSense did not opt in for a full silicone base like Pulsar has on their pad, which I think is the most premium solution. It just provides a more even feel across the entire surface and slightly dampens the sound of the glass. Instead, GameSense opted to use rubber feet, but this time around they used six, so three on each side instead of the usual four that you'll find like on the SkyPad or the Serapad Kin. That all said, I and a few others on Twitter had problems with the pad rocking from side to side or sitting a bit uneven on the desk. So when you purchase the pad out of the box, you will have 4 feet on the corners of the pad. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the other two are actually positioned in the center of the pad right here and right here. Well, I figured out that those two specific pads were the issue. Now I reapplied them several times in various different spots, like here and here or here or here along this kind of bottom and top edge. And I even put one smack dab in the middle and just used 5 in total, but nothing worked. It kept wobbling or wanting to tilt each time. When I put the feet here, so I have one in the corner, one in this corner, and one right in the middle along the long edge, and then the same on this side, this works perfectly fine. It's flat, it's even, and there's no wobbling. Now, after I messaged GameSense a couple times about this, they finally responded with the response that it seems like arm pressure has a lot to do with it, which to me, frankly, is an inadequate response because it definitely was not arm pressure. I mean, I've owned 5 glass pads and only the Sonar had this issue. Anyway, luckily it's an easy fix for me. And if you have that experience, the feet themselves have enough stickiness, you can reapply them like 5 or 6 times. I had no issue. Now, third is, of course, the most important thing here is the Surface itself, and I was again fully expecting this to perform like a lot of other pads, primarily a lot like the Superglide. But then I started seeing on Twitter for folks who got it first, you know, before I did, that it was slower, a lot slower even, and Sonar was stating it's a control glass pad. Well, fast forward to me getting it, and at first I really didn't feel the control that much, but I had a problem. At the same time of me getting this, I also started testing these two mice, the HSK Plus and the HSK Pro, which are incredibly low weight mice. So the difference was kind of really hard for me to tell there, especially on this one. I was using Dot Skates at the time. After a bit, I ended up using my Vaxi a little bit more on it, and then I started to notice the control a little bit more with the higher weight and bigger skates. But this all got me thinking, you know, it's just so damn hard to convey the speed of certain pads and the differences over just my feelings, and hoping that you fully kind of grasp that and understand it, especially for how close some of these pads are. And factoring in how many products that I get to test and have to cycle in between, it gets muddied sometimes. So I devised the Lemonade pseudoscience method to analyze pads moving forward. Some astute viewers of our hobby will have seen this particular thing before, and yes, credit due to Bearded Bob for inspiring this little setup. Also a little bit of credit to Viscose. You'll see why in a little bit. Now I'm going to explain it briefly. You can of course DM me for more questions about this whole thing. My control mouse here is the PureTrack Valor. It's a GPX clone at 70 grams. And then I slap on 200 gram weights on top of it. So this total setup here is 270 grams. The added weight provides simulated downward pressure as if, you know, you were moving the mouse yourself and pushing into the pad just a little bit. On a scale that I tested, I mean, downward pressure can range pretty wildly from 300 or 400 grams of total pressure, including the mouse. But I figured that this is close enough for a kind of lighter touch that probably a lot more gamers will have. Also, this simulated pressure accounts for more of the surface texture and the base if we're testing, you know, cloth or hybrid pads. Then I use this digital force gauge meter to record the amount of force in kilograms that is required to move the mouse from a stop to an initial continuous motion. Effectively, will give us how much initial or static friction the surface is providing. Static and initial friction is really what you will feel most, since the speed of your movement is the slowest at this point. So you're feeling more of that friction. Now, in terms of the pad measurements, I measured each pad 15 different times, 3 times in each direction of forward, left, right, downward, and a left diagonal. So moving from, you know, the center of the pad to a left diagonal to this corner. I hold the device with the same 3 fingers and provide the lightest possible touch to limit introducing extra force when it makes contact with the mouse surface. As you can see, if I just kind of push it quickly, it'll spike a lot versus doing it very slowly and deliberately, so I can get a very consistent read. By the way, this particular setting is not measuring in kilograms right now. I just wanted to quickly demonstrate what's kind of happening and how sensitive this particular sensor is. Here are the results. Each direction is individually tested and then averaged out. And then I take the summation of all the directions and average those out into kilograms. Convert the kilograms to grams because that's more easily understood. And voila, we have SkyPad at the top. Shocker. So no, but seriously, good on SkyPad for legit holding the top spot for the lowest friction. So I ranked it as the baseline here and calculated the percentage increase in force required to move the mouse off that. In the case of the Sonar, it did rank lower than the Superglide and the SkyPad, particularly 41% more force required than the SkyPad, but, and this is a big but, that 41% only equated to about a 10 gram difference in force, or the equivalent of 2 plastic credit cards. So while 41% is massive, it's more subtle than it actually may appear. Also, when you look at this chart, I just want you to know that your experience may vary. You know, it depends on your mouse, how much it weighs, the size, your skates, and how much pressure you're applying in your movements. Also, dynamic friction isn't accounted here for a couple different reasons, but that can be addressed in a later video or if someone wants to DM me. Anyway, that all being said, obviously this is a fun thing to do and it gives us at least some figures to compare for future mousepad reviews. So yes, this chart will be continuously updated and used as we move forward. Now, in actual use of the pad, yes, the increased control is felt versus a SkyPad, but it's still a smooth glass surface that is faster than cloth or hybrid pads, as you saw. So if this is your first glass pad, expect your initial experience to be that it's fast. Now for me, personally, I still prefer my Kin overall in performance and feel, and it's closest in the glass category to my favorite cloth pad, the X10 Control. Plus, the Kin is least affected by moisture and humidity. The GameSense Sonar performs pretty close to the Superglide and the SkyPad in terms of getting sticky on your skin from sweat. Anyway, that's a lot of talk, so let's wrap this up. Is this thing worth it? I mean, listen, to be fair, it's $90, and pretty much all the pads that we were talking about are at that price point for this size, and the quality overall is matching them, so it's not overpriced, but you are limited in options here. You only get one size and one color option, at least for now. That said though, if you find that the Kin was just a bit too slow and the SkyPad is just a bit too fast and you really want a consistent surface that will last you a lifetime and provide you just a little bit more control instead of pure speed, then this may be the perfect fit for you. And on that note, folks, all my socials are down below with the affiliate links for the brands that I trust and use on a daily basis. Use code LEMONADE for any peripherals to save a few bucks off of your order, or code UPGRADELEMONADE to sign up with our channel partner Surfshark to get an extra 3 months free. If you had a good time with me today, likes and subs are always appreciated. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your thoughts are on glass pads, this pad in general. But until the next Fresh Squeeze video, you know what it is, folks. Stay thirsty.